Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. We're post GitHub Universe, and we have a very special guest with us this week, Damian Brady, who's going to walk us through some of the coolest features that have come out of GitHub Universe 2021. So tune in. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. With us this week, we have an extremely special guest, Damian Brady. Welcome, Damian.
Thanks. Good to be here.
Good to have you back now from the other side. So tell everyone what you've been up to in the last few months.
Yeah. So yes, in about June 2021, I moved from Microsoft to GitHub, mainly to follow a lot of the DevOps stuff that was happening. And so I'm now in the DevRel team at GitHub, focusing on all things GitHub. But one of the more recent things that happened that you might have seen is GitHub Universe, where we made a whole bunch of announcements. It's kind of GitHub's first party major event, think Build or Ignite. Yeah, so I was gonna show you a bunch of stuff from Universe, but yeah, that's mainly what I've been doing for the last little while.
That's awesome. And there were a ton of announcements from GitHub Universe. And I know from the community, there's a lot of stuff that they wanted to see that actually got launched. And I think there's more coming down the pipeline. But if you could take it away and tell us about some of the really cool stuff that came out of GitHub Universe, that would be awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'll make sure that we get all the links to the blog post that Thomas Donkey put in his blog post about all the stuff that's at Universe. There's too many to kind of go through and show, but I want to highlight a couple that are really, you know, important to me, especially. Mm-hmm. So the biggest thing for me, I think, is the updates to GitHub Issues and projects and the whole planning and tracking side. That's been worked on for a while, and there's a lot of teams around the world who are using it as their daily driver for managing mm-hmm. their work. That's now in public beta, so you can just try that out yourself. It's, you know, it's part of GitHub, and it's a great way to manage your projects, whether they're open source or internal kind of enterprise-y projects as well. So I want to show you some of that. I want to just before we do that, maybe touch on a couple of the other things that have come out that I'm not going to talk so much about. Mm-hmm. We've done a lot of work on GitHub discussions. There's some new stuff around CI/CD with actions. You might have seen over the last year things with environments and deployments and all of that side. That's really cool. There's some brand new stuff around ephemeral runners, which basically means when a job gets queued, you can spin up a runner and then tear it down again. So we kind of fire off events that let you do that just for single jobs, which is really handy. Codespaces I am going to talk about. There's some stuff around security as well. So code scanning, we now support Ruby. Copilot is now open for people to use as well. Awesome. So no more wait list. You can just go and try it out. Just grab the extension for VS Code and use that. But yeah, Issues is the first thing I kind of want to show. And then Codespaces, I might jump into that a little bit as well.
Yeah, awesome. I have had the great opportunity to play with Issues. I'm really excited about it because it's a feature that, for lack of a better phrase, was missing from GitHub. And I think it's a big game changer. So go ahead, take it away for us and show us some Issues.
Yeah, absolutely. So I've got my, this is my little project. I don't actually have a startup idea yet, but I figure that's the last thing you need to worry about. this is my $1 billion startup. And I've already gone ahead and kind of created this grid view, I guess, or table view. Mm-hmm. And you can see the different views that you can have. There's a table view and there's a board view. So I could easily just kind of switch that to the board view and then it'll sort it by status. You know, we've got our to-do, in progress, done. Yeah. You get all your normal stuff like dragging them around and being able to manage. You can see your tags, your labels. You can also kind of rename it. You can sort, you can group, you can filter, you can change what appears in there as well. So I've got the title, assignees, labels, status. There's also mm-hmm. some hidden ones. So I could put the milestone on there. Or the other thing is these issues are across repositories. Awesome. So that's really handy in organizations where you might have multiple repos, where people are doing work across multiple repositories. I could add items. So let's just switch back to the table view. It's a little bit easier. And I'll add an item for a different repository. So this is my $1 billion startup, but let's say I wanted to do like something in my equipment repository and say, mm-hmm. oh, the green screen is super important for this project. So that belongs to a different repository and a different set of issues. But I can put it all in here. One of the really new things that's come out as well is I can add a new field, and there's a new type called iteration. So what we found is you could always kind of do this just having like a text column as a custom column, but people tended to use iterations as like a first class citizen. It's great for managing your Scrum projects or just Agile projects. So I could have this iteration starting on particular dates and then, you know, how long they go for and create these iterations and manage things that way as well. So like there's tons of stuff to show you in here. One other really good thing is workflows based on what's happening in your project as well. So for example, when a issue is closed, set the status to that card to done. Or if a code review is approved, maybe I can do something or other else, you know. And so this is all being worked on, these workflows, but it's an awesome way to kind of manage, you know, that board and that grid and things like that.
No, I think this is awesome. This is one, probably for me, one of the biggest features I've seen come out of GitHub Universe this year that was highly anticipated. How we organize, you know, our agile practices, have visibility into it end to end. Spanning repos is something that I probably get asked like several times a week. How do we do that in Azure DevOps, et cetera? And to see that come all out off the gate, awesome. That's really cool. Yeah,
definitely. And like, there's lots more coming with this. They're actively working on this constantly. So if you start to use it, have a look and try it out and give us some feedback on how it's working for you.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's so cool. That's really, really cool. I'm so excited to work with it. I have a project coming up where I'm going to be instating projects and blogging about it. So I'm super excited that it's out and we can share it with the public now.
Yeah, definitely. One quick thing, if you want to actually set these up, if you go to your organizations, it's at the organization level. So I'll just find it. Actually, here are my organizations. I'm looking at Demo Visa Inc. And so in settings, and I clicked the wrong button. Did I? Nope. Projects. There we go. So these are the settings for projects. So you can enable it for the organization for specific repositories and things like that. Or, and I'll just go to the URL because I know it, orgs and then projects. And you can see there's still the old project. So if you wanted to use existing projects, that's still there. Or projects beta is the one that you want to look at as well. So really easy to kind of get started with this as well. Yeah.
Really cool. Awesome. 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 So show us what's next. What else came out? What's awesome? What's cool? What else do you have for us?
The bit that's really, like, honestly, has changed the way I work. And I'm going to say, I thought this was a gimmick when it first came out, was I don't know if whether you've seen the GIFs and things like that of people pressing the dot key on a repository. I honestly, when I first saw it, I thought, it's a bit gimmicky. People aren't going to do that. I use it all the time. Yep. Like, seriously, what it essentially is, I'm just going to hit dot now so you can see in real time how long it takes. What it really is just like a headless or a serverless kind of VS code for a repository. It's a little bit more than that, though. So, I mean, I can absolutely just edit stuff in here. So I could, this is just a little haiku project. I can make a change and, you know, submit a pull request if I don't have access to that repo. But because I do, I'm an owner, I can just commit that change and do it directly. So for small changes that don't require me to kind of compile or debug or anything like that, this is an awesome way of doing it. But I mentioned it's a little bit more than that as well. There's a really cool feature in here where if you go to a pull request, and let's see if we have one in here. No, I'm just going to go to a different repository that I know has a pull request. So this one, there's some closed pull requests, but I'll do that anyway. Let's reopen one of these just so I can show it. If I'm reviewing a pull request, so this is a pull request that somebody submitted. If I'm reviewing that and I hit dot on this pull request page, when I'm not focused on an entry field, I'll get the same thing. So I'll get VS Code, kind of a web editor, but I'm in the context of this pull request. So it's not just modifying the code. Now, here's the pull request that the person made. They literally, made this change themselves, and I can review it directly in here in that kind of context that I'm used to. That's awesome. Really, really handy. Yeah, it's just so useful. That's kind of the thing that's available immediately for basically any repository. You can do that right now, and I would strongly encourage you to do it. The other thing, though, that's worth showing, I think, is if you do need to compile and do need to debug, and that's Codespaces. So I've set one up ahead of time, but you can do a new Codespace and just create it directly from a repository if you have access. I'm just going to open this one because it'll be a tiny bit quicker, not a lot quicker. One of the things that we mentioned at Universe was that we've basically moved the entire GitHub development team to Codespaces for GitHub. So github.com/github/github. So what you see when you get to github.com. Mm-hmm. And everybody uses Codespaces from zero to a brand new Codespace, ready to code, ready to do work, is about 10 seconds now. And that's all the dependencies. It's this virtual machine that you can use, debug and run and all that kind of stuff, just as you would. So this is now VS Code. I've got a terminal. You know, I can run everything. This is all running on the cloud, but through my browser, or I could open this VS Code locally. And yeah, I can debug this application. It's running in the cloud, it's running Node, and it'll take a second to spin up. But I can debug this thing without having to install anything on my local machine, which means I could do this from my desktop, or I could do it from an iPad in a coffee shop.
And I think we see a lot of people. So like when I was in engineering working with customers, we had a lot of the developers and the engineering teams we worked with at customer sites didn't have access to their machines. They were locked down. If they tried to run any kind of dev container, they were like super locked down, took a while to run. Codespaces made all of that setup time like nil. So seeing this get even more, you know, resources and time and insights put into it's been awesome because we use it a lot with customers. It's portable. And again, like it doesn't matter where you're working in the world. It's also a secure development environment. Like it's so, so cool. So they've done a really good job in making that, like, you're right, easy to spin up in about 10 seconds, get your whole development environment. Absolutely love it.
Because I remember my first job, this is decades ago, when I started in software development, it took me like a week to get a computer at the time. Yep. But then when I got one, it was like another week to get all the stuff set up on the computer, the dependencies. And then if I'd changed project midway through, like you can burn a few days just getting everything set up. If you're using Codespaces, you just go to that other repository and create a Codespace, and it's configured for that repository, for that, you know, piece of work, for that project. It's honestly a game changer. And one that I thought, this might be a little bit gimmicky, but seriously, once I've started using it and once we've started using it internally, it's just changed the world, basically.
Absolutely. And I think it gives every engineer, every developer the same development environment. So, I mean, I work on teams with, you know, half the people have Macs, half the people have Windows devices. For running a dev container, setting up a dev container is great, but it has its problems locally on Windows machines, the whole change in licensing to Docker desktop, like all of it's kind of like throwing some things through a loop. So now, same thing, we're just using Codespaces and it's so easy to use.
It is, yeah. So they've put lots and lots of work into it. It's awesome. It's great. I'm fusing about this, but I've been able to dig into it a little bit lately. And there'll be another link I can give you as well. I did a couple of sessions at Universe on Codespaces. And there's a couple more as well in there as well. So if you want to have a look at it, put the link in.
That'd be great. I think our users would love that as well. Cool. Damian, that was awesome. There were some amazing updates that came out of GitHub Universe. I think GitHub has delivered so many cool features moving forward with security, you know, productivity, just all these things that we've kind of been waiting for and getting Chinese whispers about. So it's great to see them come to fruition.
Yeah, absolutely. No, it's been exciting to work on.
Well, thanks for coming back onto the DevOps Lab. It's been great to kind of reverse the roles and host you on. Definitely. Please don't be a stranger and come back on and show some more cool GitHub stuff.
Yeah, absolutely will. Thanks for having me.
All right. Thanks, everyone. And tune in next time for potentially some more GitHub stuff with Damian.